Hello everyone and welcome to our English lesson today. Our lesson today is about phrasal verbs. I think it's very necessary for each student to learn about phrasal verbs and how to use phrasal verbs. Therefore, you may ask yourself or ask me, what's a phrasal verb? Phrasal verb is a verb that consists of two parts. The first part is always a short verb like give, turn, come, get, etc. And the second part is a preposition like up, down, in, on. Here you are some examples. Number one, you can give up smoking. So here, the phrasal verb give up, with the meaning quit. You can say, you can quit smoking. Number two, you can fill in a form. So the phrasal verb here fill in, with the meaning like complete. You can complete a form. Drop off means take someone to a place. For example, we drop Ahmed off at school. It means we take Ahmed to school, then we leave him there. See off means to say goodbye at airport or station. For example, I see Omar off at the airport. What does see off as a phrasal verb mean? It means we said farewell for Omar at the airport. Now there are some important points about phrasal verbs. The first important point about phrasal verb is that some phrasal verbs do not have only one meaning, but they have more than one meaning or two meanings. Number one, turn down means reduce. Could you turn down the TV, please? Second meaning, turn down means reject. He turned down our invitation. It means he rejected our invitation. The second important point about phrasal verb is that most phrasal verbs that take an object can be separated by the object. For example, you should give up the job. Here, the phrasal verb give up, and the object is this job. So, the object may come between the verb and the preposition. You should give the job up. Or you can use or replace the object with a suitable pronoun. You should give it up. Instead of you should give the job up, we have used a suitable pronoun instead of the job. The second one, let's pick up the boxes. Here the phrasal verb pick up and the object boxes. So we can use the boxes in two different ways. Let's pick the boxes up between the verb and the preposition up, or we use a suitable pronoun instead of the boxes, them. Let's pick them up. Now it's time for the exercise. Please try to do this exercise and send me your answers. And before I end my lesson today, I'd like to say something very important for you. It's advice. Please don't waste your time in memorizing the phrasal verbs, but you can learn them in contexts, dialogues, conversations, and something like this. I hope by the end you have added something very useful to your English language. Thanks a lot for watching. See you later.